Hello, welcome to Mozilla Business and Design. In this space, we are going to take you on Revit 2023. Here we are going to design spiral staircase. Please, after you have watched the video, kindly click on subscribe button. Thank you. So here, we are going to design spiral staircase. But the first line of action is to get a foundation, I mean normal base, where the spiral staircase is going to stay up based upon. Now on your ground floor, click on floor, create a floor, architectural floor, use rectangle that line, then create, use something smaller so that it will be very accommodating on the screen. Just type, let's say, like 2000. So 2000 by 2000. So you just want to make it visible on our screen. Say please close. Now zoom in. Now go to staircase, click on architecture, go to staircase and click. So do not use, there are so many other methods of doing using modifying created tools. But you don't use any of this one except this create sketch. So click on create sketch here in the boundary. So click on a circle, come to this thing, then click, type 100 to enter. All right, so now another one, let the radius be more bigger. So let's say 1100. Enter. Right. So here you have the boundary in which the staircase is going to stay in within. So click on riser. Riser will define your steps. The steps you're going to take to the next level. New spiral staircase is one of the staircases that doesn't have landing. So here is a landingless staircase your design. So you do by four, divide it into four cardinal junction. Now as you're done with that, now within this you are going to start rotating. How many steps did you want to climb before you reach another floor? That's what determine. But I usually use 15 degree for a rotation of from one riser to another. So here I'm going to do it by using, press escape on your keyboard, click on the riser line, say click on rotate. You make sure that you check that the copy is checked, is marked. So if it's not checked, if it's not marked, you need to click on it and let it be marked. So you can shift the central line and rotate it at angle 15 degrees, like I have said. So enter, press. So if this happened, the next thing to do is to rotate again. Click on rotate, drag this to the middle. So click from here, click on this. So you do the same thing, rotate, drag this to the middle, that dotted arrow, make sure you click on it and drag it. So move from the former to the, so you do the same thing once we're able to complete the first cardinal . So after you're done with that, now it's complete. So after you've done that, select the new ones, that just new one you create, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So select 5 of them and go to rotate again. Click on that arrow, click on it and drag it to the middle. Then click the first line and go to the second cardinal line you drew that, and then click on it. So you have it there. So do the same thing here. Drag it again. from that line, take it, so you have completed the three segments. So the first segment, we are going to leave it down for another floor landing. So you shift this, the boundary line, because the boundary line used to be divided into two segments. So you take one of segment and take it to 1/3. So you're making half. So half of that one is my 1/3 of the whole line. So you do the same thing for this, the middle boundary line, the smaller boundary line. Take it. So have you done that? The next thing to do is to draw the part, the stair part. So the stair part, use the same thing, use circle from the middle, click on it and stretch it to something in between. So that will be like the middle of it. So there now, you stretch again to the 5 inch here. So that's it. So after you have done that, you just click on finish editing. So as you've done that, you can decide to click final. Let's say click the final. So you have your spiral staircase being drawn. So when you look at it from elevations, anywhere in elevation you see your spiral staircase, this is the floor we do, this is the spiral staircase. Like this now, the floor level is higher than it, so you can click on it and take it like 3000. Depends. So you have your spiral staircase. Now you can click on this spiral staircase and change the type. Let's just use monolithic. That is my best kind of staircase. I always use. You say delete the type. Yes. So you have it. I don't like this railing as well. Use the one that say bottom fill. So you see. So you have something designing. So now you can go to 3D. Go click on 3D default and see what we have done here. So when you climb from the beginning of the staircase, you're going to climb and continue stepping to the upper level. So now from the floor level 2, you can decide to create another floor so that it has something unique and similar. So click on it, select the line, select this line, so draw. So just assuming that this is another floor where the staircase is going to land on. So click on finish. So go back to 3D default. Click on it. You see? So when you climb from ground, change the color. So let's come to okay. When you climb from ground, go like that. So you are going to land at the top of the staircase. You see. So that is how to design spiral staircase. There is no any other way about it. In the middle, you can decide to put a column within this middle so that it will have something to rest on. So that is it for that. Thank you for watching. Kindly click on subscribe button.